they were flying from Teesside to Edinburgh. Maybe the Grumman Tiger. So let's get going, shall we? Seems to be quite busy here at Teesside. So what we need is the St. Abbs VOR 112.5 to be programmed in to the, or tuned in I should say, to the radio. Okay, it's already in our COM2 for the second leg, and the COM2 we are, or NAV2 I should say, once we've got tuned in, we'll be able to set our course 88 degrees. No, sorry, it was, yeah, maybe no, it's 244 degrees. And over here, one with 2.5, and that 108.9 is the ILS into Edinburgh. So we should have everything we need. We can set the OBS for the first part of the journey to be 341, I believe. 341. And we also need our runway heading, which is going to be 228. So that should line up there. Let's set our compass. This is 280. Let's get our atmospheric
Actual call, November, Victor, airport information, Bravo, 1120, Zulu, weather, wind, 281 at 6, visibility, 10,000, sky condition, 4,800, scattered temperature, 14, dew point, 2, altimeter, 3021, advice on initial contact, you have information, Bravo. Echo.
Alright, final check, fuel on, mixture wrench, throttle on, idle, lights on, mags on, instrument set, everything looks good. Stop off to the side here and do a run up. So we're airborne, and we are turning towards the correct direction of the heading mode until such time as we pick up these apps VOR. Once we've picked up the VOR, we'll then engage app mode on the autopilot to follow that to the VOR beacon.
Okay.
Right then, we have lock on the beacon, so we can either just switch on to nav mode and let it swoop around to the right and follow that, or we can just adjust our angle we want and then pop it into nav mode. Right, so after this gentle left turn, we'll be flying directly at the St. Abbs of Yellow. Needle for that one is bit off-center. That's because we're too close to them to be accurate. Once we get over the beacon, we're going to switch over to Nav 2, which is this OBS instrument here, which is quite funky, which is set to 288 degrees. And the 2 that it should change from. Select 288 degrees. May not be exactly on the line, but as it moves further away and the signal gets more accurate, it'll fix itself and move back onto the line. You see this string of lines to the right will go off to the left as we go over the beacon, and then as it fixes itself, there we go, we're over the beacon. So we're going to switch to the new heading, and as it fixes itself, this will go down, so it's just a square in the middle. North, see off to our right. Okay, so now we're firmly on Nav 2. We can switch the frequency of Nav 1 over to be the ILS for the runway. Runway heading, which is 241. You don't have to set this for an ILS, but it's just nice, gives you a nice visual indication of how close you are to the runway center line. Okay, it seems that the Nav 2 is now accurate enough to put itself onto course, so it's turning us to the left to get rid of this, these paths to the left. Now it's straightening up, and as we come out of the turn, that should be on just a square in the middle.
try with this one. You